Despite living what I considered a healthy, active lifestyle, I started getting fat. At age 30, I noticed my metabolism slowing down, my weight increasing, and the temptation to get caught in life's bad habits, such as eating out to excess, drinking, and living a sedentary lifestyle intensifying. Instead of yielding to these pressures, I hired a film crew and decided to use myself as a guinea pig in a fitness experiment. Over the months that followed, I learned how to exercise in a safe and effective manner, rediscovered the joys of healthy home-cooked meals, and achieved some noteworthy results. Now, I'm editing the footage I compiled in order to create a new documentary, which I call I Want Abs. If you're someone who wants to get in shape but don't know how to do it, I Want Abs is for you. My movie's on schedule to be released on June 1st, 2016, but you can pre-order it now at iwantabsmovie.com. While I put the final touches on my feature film, I've created this mini-series to give you a sneak peek of how I trained to lose weight, shed fat, and build muscle. If you like what you see, perhaps you should consider doing the workouts with me. I'll include the guidelines for the workouts at the end of each video. If you're a newbie like I was, I recommend working out 2 to 3 times per week for 50 minutes. And you can absolutely positively mix and match the workouts from these videos in any way you like. Thank you for watching and good luck. Sergei, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Now what I want to do is once you get in the pool and I want you just to swim a lap. What I'm going to do is do a stroke analysis. Okay. Swimming is all about technique, okay? I don't want you to think about anything on this first length. We're just going to swim one length and then I'm going to meet you at the other end of the pool and I'm going to pull your stroke apart and we're going to work on stroke mechanics.
Cool.
Because as you improve your technique in the pool, the faster you're going, the easier it is. So why don't you put your goggles on, jump in the pool, and we'll do it.
Do I need anything but goggles for this?
I think the goggles are fine. I don't think you need a swim cap.
Any specific stroke that I'm doing?
Let's start with the crawl, the freestyle. Yeah, the freestyle. Now I'm going to give you 2 little tips.
Okay.
I don't want you to think about it too much. Thinking can be a dreadful affliction, especially when you're swimming. You want to focus on the rotation, okay? Want to rotate through the water, and the kick is from your hips, okay? That's the only thing I want you to think about. And we'll just swim a 25, which is one length. All right, you have a good stroke.
Good.
All right, 2 things I want to really work on.
Uh-huh.
You're lifting your head just a little bit,
uh-huh.
Okay?
That's the breathing part.
Yeah, that's the breathing part. You want to rotate more,
uh-huh.
Okay? So really, if you don't rotate enough, you're going to have to lift your head to breathe and your legs are going to drop down. And then intuitively, you start kicking a lot more.
Okay.
So we want to have more rotation and you have like a 12-beat kick. All right, want to have a 4-beat kick. You're going like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You want 1, 2, 3, 4, okay?
Okay.
Now how we do that is there's something called a fingertip dragging drill I want to try. Only thing I want you to think about is as you're bringing your stroke back here, you're going to drag your fingertips in along the surface. That's going to force you to have a high elbow and really help you rotate a little bit more. Does that make sense? Also, you're breathing every 4th stroke.
Every 4th stroke.
You're going like 1, 1, 2, 3, breathe. You either want to breathe every other stroke or preferably bilaterally, mm-hmm. which is every 3rd stroke.
So you're switching sides.
Yeah, so you take a breath and then you go 1, 2, breathe, 1, 2, breathe. Now, do you feel?
As I'm going, I'm dragging like this?
Yes, yeah. So let's just focus on just the fingertip dragging drill. Okay, this is gonna give you enough rotation so that you'll be able to breathe. All right? So let's do fingertip dragging drill, 1 length. Good. That's okay.
Oh my God, there's no. So much to
I know. You don't want to think about too many things. So let's just finish up to the end there and fingertip dragging drill. All right. Normally when people first do that, it freaks them out. But see right there, did you feel yourself rotating a lot more?
Yeah.
That's the rotation that you want, okay? So I want you just to remember that, okay? I want you to rest. I'm gonna give you a nice long rest in between each set.
Cool.
We're gonna do another 25, and it's not, I don't want you to do the fingertip dragging drill, but I want you to rotate as much as you were just rotating that last time. Because what you were doing, when you first went down, you were maybe rotating about 25, 30 degrees. I want you to rotate 45 degrees. Okay, and you do that by having a nice high elbow and then entering out. So let's swim another 25. Good, good rotation. All right, that was much better.
That felt better.
Was it easier?
Way easier.
Now you know that your technique is improving because it's gonna be a lot easier and you're gonna go a lot faster, okay? Swimming is so incredibly technical. There's so many variables that come together. The first thing that I always wanna work on is getting that rotation down. The next thing is stroke length. You're kind of hurrying up your stroke. So you really don't wanna hurry up your stroke. So as you enter, you're gonna extend out and have a nice long stroke length, okay?
Right, now I'm just kind of enjoying each length.
Yeah, yeah. Don't fight the pool. The pool will always kick your butt. Yeah. You know, you can be a world champion swimmer, and if you try to fight it, you're gonna have a miserable time. So it's all about nice long stroke length. Try to get into a rhythm.
Okay.
Also, I noticed you're breathing every other stroke, okay? Because I want you to get enough oxygen. And for right now, if you're comfortable just breathing on the right side, that's cool. So you're gonna take a breath, stroke, breath. Okay, and we can work on bilateral breathing later. But basically what I want you to do is try to focus on having a nice long stroke length. So right now your stroke length is pretty short.
Okay.
And let's say you go 25 stroke lengths across the pool.
Okay.
If we can go to 20 stroke lengths across the pool by having a longer stroke length, you're conserving, 20% of your energy.
Okay.
So the fewer the stroke lengths, the better. Don't fight the pull, try to get into a rhythm. Nice long stroke length,
okay,
and high elbow, good rotation. Let's swim another 25. Yeah, good. That's good. Whoops. All right, much better. But you're getting trying to get the coordination down and the timing down, okay? Have you ever used a pull buoy?
Never.
Ah, we're gonna use one now. And let's see. This is a pull buoy right here, okay? This goes between your thighs, okay? This is basically so you can just work on your pull. So you're not gonna kick. It's gonna do a couple things. It's gonna keep your body afloat on the surface, so you're gonna have to have good rotation or you're gonna have to lift your head to breathe, okay? So don't fight the water when you have this on, okay? You don't have to kick, so you're gonna be conserving energy because you still have like an 8-beat kick. You're still wasting a lot of energy kicking. This is gonna keep the lower body on the surface because you wanna rotate on the surface, okay? And really focus on good rotation, turning your head to breathe, and try to get the timing down. Okay, so let's try this. It's called a pull buoy.
So no kicking, just...
No kicking, because that's gonna keep you on the surface. Ideally, like when you're doing a triathlon or an long distance swim, you wanna just kick like about 4-beat kick where it's 1, 2, 3, 4. And that keeps your legs on the surface. Because in the crawl stroke, your kick only gives you 10% of your forward momentum. Right now with like a 10 to 12 beat kick, you're probably doing 40 to 50% of your energy in your kick, where we only want 10%. One really important thing, again, don't fight the water, okay?
Uh-huh.
Nice high elbow, have a good rotation, and just try to get into that rhythm, okay? Don't think three-dimensionally where your hands are or anything like that, because you'll freak yourself out, all right? Thinking can be a dreadful affliction, all right? Rotation, and let's sumo 25. Three. Good, that's good. All right, actually you were going great.
Really?
How did that feel? Pretty weird?
I felt weird. I think that I'm rotating one way more than the other.
You are, because eventually I want you to do bilateral breathing. Uh-huh. Actually, let's try that.
Okay.
We're gonna try one length of bilateral breathing, okay?
And so then when I take my breath, do you want me to rotate enough so that when I go to take a breath, it's no extra work, or do I actually?
No, actually, it is no extra work. It's all about the rotation.
So I'm actually going like this every
time. You're rotating through the water. So as you have that nice long stroke length, you know, you enter the water, and then right here, and that's when you take the breath,
uh-huh.
And then boom, go right in. Does that make sense?
One, two, breath.
Yep.
One, two, breath.
Yep, try to breathe bilateral. It's every third stroke cycle.
Okay.
Okay? And let's use the pull buoy. We'll use the pull buoy. Slow it down and try to get into the rhythm,
okay?
Putting all these variables together, again, swimming is extremely technical. All right, bilateral breathing, rotation, let's swim at 25. Breathe. Yes, that was your best lap. That looked great.
I felt better.
How did it feel?
Felt faster.
Yeah, you were a lot faster. You were a lot more efficient, okay? Because again, the pull buoy was holding you on the surface.
Yeah.
You were breathing every third stroke.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people, they get in the habit of just breathing every other stroke on one side. That can kind of throw you off balance. Like the time before last, you felt like you weren't rotating enough on one side. With the bilateral breathing, it kind of puts everything back into balance. So it's super duper important. Your head down. All right. It's I could hear your brain working like about midway through. It's like you're thinking too much. Try not to think. Okay? Work on one thing at a time. Nice and gentle. The rotation. You've actually got a really good stroke, really powerful stroke. But we're putting all the timing together. That's what's super super duper important.
And so you really want me to, I think I'm going to try just cuz I'm but my goal is to get to the other side, you know? So I think
mm-hmm.
I'm gonna slow it down to really.
Yeah, focus on the rotation. And again, try not to think of where your body is three-dimensionally in the water.
Okay.
Because you'll freak yourself out. Let's do one more length with the pull buoy. All right, okay. Bilateral breathing, rotation, rotation, rotation. Good, nice high elbow. Breathe. That was awesome. That was your best lap.
Cool.
That looked great.
That felt better.
You weren't kicking because you don't need to kick with a pull buoy.
Uh-huh.
And did you notice your whole body was turning? Okay.
Yeah.
With a four-beat kick, one, two, three, four. The hips are going to rotate in conjunction with the shoulders.
Okay.
All right? Let's take the pull buoy out. Now you're going to start kicking. Try to have that four-beat kick. All right?
One, two, three, four. So each
yes.
stroke is two kicks.
Yeah, but just slow your kick down. Right? Just try to slow your kick down. All right, let's swim at 25. Bilateral breathing, good rotation.
No problem.
It's all right. It's okay. I heard your brain thinking. Don't forget to kick. All right.
So, yeah, the timing of the kick is completely off.
Actually, I want to really work on your kick right now. Okay, we have worked on the fundamentals of your pull, which is good rotation, good stroke length, turning your head to breathe. You're still kicking down here. The kick is from the hips, all right? So think of each leg as a giant fin, okay? The kick is from the hips, not from down here, okay? The kick is actually a harder thing for people to get than the pull. Your pull looks pretty good. You've got good rotation and good stroke length. But now we want to kick from the hips, okay? So let's swim another 25. Let's keep the bilateral breathing, okay? And try to focus in on getting into that rhythm, that bilateral breathing into the rhythm, and kick from the hips. And try not to think too much, man. Thinking can be a dreadful affliction. All right, kick from the hips. Good, good rotation. All right, much better, much better. What size is your foot?
Like an 8.
I want to get some zoomers. Oh, those are too small. Yeah. Ah, here we go. Ah, perfect. These are called zoomers, okay? You don't want to train with the really long fins. You want to use the short ones. This is going to give you a little bit more propulsion and really help you kick from the feet, kick from the hips, all right? So let's try those. Those might be... it might be a little too big. How do they feel?
Good.
Okay, good. Good. So now I really want to work on your kick, man.
All right.
All right. The mantra for the kick, kick from the hips and floppy feet. You're still pretty stiff. You want your hips to be moving, okay? And you want your feet to be flopping. Now, if you try to flop your feet, you won't. Right now, you're kind of flexing your feet. So kick from the hips and floppy feet. Basically, kick from the hips. Relax your legs,
okay?
And of course, in the back of your mind, you want to have a nice high elbow, good rotation, bilateral breathing, nice long stroke length. All right, let's try another 25. Good. Breathe, yeah. Yeah, that was a 6-beat kick. We're getting there, man. How did it feel?
Certain strokes did feel easier, much
yeah.
easier.
Yeah, what I want you to really focus in on is that feel right now, that rotation through the water. You were kicking from the hips, and your feet were flopping a little bit. You're bending your knees a little too much. Remember, the kick isn't from here, okay. It's from here. And good bilateral breathing. I think you're getting the timing down, okay? A lot of this is just repetition, repetition, repetition. Yeah. Before you go, one thing that kind of helps a lot of people is focus, you see the lane line here?
Yeah.
Focus, think of yourself as straddling that lane line, rotating, pulling yourself forward, not wasting any energy on the horizontal or the vertical. Does that make sense?
No.
You're just rotating.
Okay. Not
wasting energy pulling yourself forward, like throughout your entire body. Let's say, pretend there's a pole going through your body. You're rotating along that pole, pulling yourself forward. Does that make sense? All right. All right, kick from the hips and floppy feet. Good. All right, that looked really good. How'd it feel?
I feel goofy, but I mean, I'm getting there.
Less energy,
yeah. Before, yeah.
Yeah. Swimming is very functional.
Yeah.
You know, you're ambulating three-dimensionally through space in a curvy or linear fashion. You're rotating through. So that was probably your best lap.
Wow.
That looked really good. All right?
Yeah.
One thing you are doing, especially in the left side, is you're crossing over.
With the left side.
Yeah. Yeah, with the left arm. Crossing over meaning you want to extend out towards 12 o'clock, straight ahead.
Okay.
On the left side, you're kind of crossing over to 1 o'clock, okay? So anytime that you waste energy this way or this way, you want to be really narrow, pulling yourself forward, rotating forward. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay, so let's do another 25. This next length, I want you to swim it in as few stroke lengths as possible.
Okay.
All right? So really extend out. Don't pause.
Okay.
It's one continuous stroke.
Okay.
All right? Don't pause. And let's swim another 25. Good. Nice long stroke length. Yeah, looks good. Good rotation. Yeah, you did not cross over. Did you see the difference?
I didn't. Yeah, I did.
Yeah. One of the things you do not want to do, and so many people will just get in the pool and swim a mile. They'll just swim, you know, 500 or 1,000 or 1,500 straight. Right now, what I want you to do is just doing these 25s, working on technique. Later on, you can go to like 50s, 100s, 250s. But right now, technique is everything. Your technique is so much better than when you first started. It's radically different. Does it feel radically different?
I mean,
yeah. It does.
I feel at home.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you're not fighting the water. And so many guys, you know, they'll try to muscle through the water. The water will always kick your butt. Now we're going to do some 50s. I'm going to prove to you that you're a lot more efficient now.
Okay.
So we're going to do a down and back, which is a 50, two lengths or one lap. Okay? And I'm going to give you plenty of time. This is a clock. We're going to let this all go all the way around, and I want you to leave on the 30 seconds. Okay, we're going to do five 50s down and back with a lot of time in between. What I really want you to focus on this one, or on these 50s down and back, don't fight the water. You know, have a nice long stroke length. Don't waste any energy with your kick. Your kick is so much better.
Okay?
And with the zoomers, you should be feeling your feet flopping a little bit.
Yeah.
And they're flopping, man. The kick is from the hips, and you want floppy feet. You still have 20 seconds. I'm going to give you lots of time. This is one of the things that you can do when you're in the pool. You can use the clock. We're going to do a set of five 50s on the 2 minute.
Okay.
All right? You still got 10 seconds. I'm going to tell you when to go. And of course, focus on the feel, man, that rotation. Nice long stroke length. All right. Are you ready?
Yep.
And go. No fingertip dragging drill. That's it. Okay. This isn't fingertip dragging drill. This isn't fingertip dragging drill. I'm sorry. No fingertip dragging drill. But that was good. So we're going to do this on the minute and a half. So you left in the 30. We're going to go on the 60 for number two. How did that feel?
Felt good, but again, I'm rushing. I'm like.
You are. You're hurrying it up, man. And when you hurry it up.
My breath when
yeah.
I rush,
yeah. Yeah. If you hurry it up, what's going to happen is your stroke length is going to get shorter. You're going to expend a lot more energy, and you're going to go slower.
Mm-hmm.
What you want to do is nice long stroke length. Don't hurry it up. You will go faster and you'll expend less energy. If you look at Olympic swimmers, you know, it looks like they're barely moving because they're so efficient. Think efficiency. All right, we got another 5 seconds. We're gonna do this on a minute and a half. All right, long stroke length, a 50 down and back. Go. Yeah. Nice and slow. Don't fight the water. Good, good rotation. Good, good kick. Much better. How'd that feel?
Better.
Excellent. Rest. We're going to go on the 30. I want to get your heart rate. Take these fingers. I'm going to tell you when to start. You got a beat?
Yep.
Start counting now. Stop.
11.
Okay, 110. That's good. That's good. That means that you're not anaerobic. All right, we're at the 30 seconds. This is number 3, down and back. Nice long stroke length. And go. Good. Yes! How'd that feel? That looked great.
That looked really good.
Yeah, you had a 4-beat kick. You were kicking from the hips. Your feet were flopping. You did not lift your head, which would have dropped your body. Your body was on the surface. You had really good positioning. We got 2 more of these. We're going to go on the 60. We still got 20 seconds. It's looking good, man.
Thanks,
George. See, as you get more efficient, the faster you go and the easier it is. All right? And swimming, you're doing literally, you know, in a swim workout, you're doing thousands of core rotations, which is why swimmers...
Roman twists, huh?
Yeah, yeah, Roman twists in the pool. Oh. Basically, yeah. All right, let's do number 4. And go. Good rotation. That's it, and 50. Excellent, and rest. One of the things that you're doing really well is you're following through. A lot of people, earlier on when you were hurrying up your stroke, you were coming out right here. You're following through, and that's adding on an extra foot to your stroke length. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Also down there, when you do an open turn, you hit the wall here, push out under the water, come to the surface and start your stroke. When you're on top like that, you're causing that friction. Does that make sense? As you take a nice deep breath, get in, and then as soon as you start coming, you're blowing it out.
Okay. So I'm blowing it as I'm swimming.
Yes, as you're swimming. Yeah. Yeah. Again, you want to get into a rhythm. Don't hold your breath, and just get into that rhythm. The more you do this, the more it's going to be second nature.
Okay.
All right. This is number 5. Are you ready? And go. Open water turn, under the water, push out. Good, start the stroke. Yes, and that, my friend, is a 4-beat kick. Did you feel it? Did you feel, you should be really feeling your hips rotating in conjunction with your upper body.
Uh-huh.
Should just be getting easier and easier. So you went from a 12-beat kick to a 4-beat kick.
Wow.
All right, which is really what you want. How did that feel? You were riding on the surface?
Yeah.
It looked really, really good. Okay, now we're gonna go back to 25s. We're gonna do 6 25s, which is just one length.
Cool.
All right, I want you to really focus on not crossing over on the left side and having that nice high elbow. By having the nice high elbow, it's gonna open up your chest. It's going to keep your head from lifting, and it's going to give you the proper rotation. All right? So we're going to do 6 25s with about a 20-second rest. Only thing I want you to think about, not crossing over on the left side. That's a big thing. All right? And let's swim a 25. He's got a really good stroke. Looks really good. That's it. Yes, and rest 20 seconds. How did that feel? You weren't going all over there. That looked really good. You did not cross over, not once. And even when you're crossing over, you're going pretty straight. But the thing about being in the pool, you're, again, ambulating three-dimensionally through the water. So it's going to feel kind of weird because you're rotating through it. That looked really good. That was your best 25.
Cool.
How'd it feel?
Great.
Yeah, it's getting easier and easier, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, you got 5 seconds. We're going to do 5 more of these. Don't cross over. And go. Nice high elbow. That's it. Yeah. And the feet are a flopping. Are you feeling that?
I am, yeah.
Yeah. The kick is from the hips. You're kicking from here now. You're not kicking from here. Your feet are flopping a little bit. And those floppy feet, you want your feet to be like this. That's going to give you a little bit more lift and keep you on the surface. Cool. See, right now as you're swimming, you're right on the surface. When we first started, when you were trying to muscle through the water, you were like this at an angle, which is a lot less efficient. Plus, your stroke length is a lot longer. It's about a foot longer. And you have the proper rotation. So it's looking really good.
Thanks, John.
You're welcome. Isn't swimming awesome? I try to talk all my clients into the pool, and every client that didn't want to go and they kind of hated swimming, they were very inefficient. Uh-huh. And once they had the proper technique, they fell in love with it. Because it's a lot easier. It's a lot easier right now than it was when you first started, right?
It really is. To everybody watching, I thought I was a pretty good swimmer. I'd never had professional instruction, but the idea of coming into a pool and actually swimming for fitness wasn't appealing. And I can comprehend it now.
Good.
It's a completely different sport, pretty much.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and actually you had a good natural stroke. We just had to increase your rotation and increase your stroke length. That stroke length is real important. The three things that we really fixed with your stroke is the rotation, your stroke length, and you're not wasting 50% of your energy kicking. And most people, that's what we're doing. So you have a nice longer stroke length, you have the proper rotation, and now your kick is right. All right? Let's do 4 more of these. We got 4 more 25s.
Right.
How's the energy level, man?
It's high.
Yeah.
High to extreme.
All right. So nice long stroke length. Don't cross over. Let's swim another 25. Excellent. Rest 20 seconds. All right. Now, did you notice you did something a little bit different that time? You notice what it was?
I noticed I crossed a couple times and...
You hesitated. Actually, you kind of stopped. You don't want to do that. It's one continual motion.
Yeah.
As you extend out, you're extending out, but then you just follow through. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And you did cross over a couple of times, okay? We got 2 more 25s. On these last 2 25s, really focus on nice high elbow and not crossing over, because that's a big issue.
Okay.
All right, let's do it. Don't cross over. It's good. Excellent. Rest 20 seconds. We got 1 more 25. Great looking kick. You were kicking from the hips. Yeah, look, it's so much better and so much easier, right?
Yeah.
Key in on this last one, just key into the feel. So next time you're in the pool, If you start being inefficient, you know what it's like to be efficient, and just focus on that feel. Now, did you get what I was talking about rotating on that plane, pulling yourself forward?
Yeah.
That's what you want. It's really a rotation. You're rotating through the water. So let's do one more 25. Do not cross over, kick from the hips. Good job. Excellent. Now I'm going to give you a minute's rest, and we're going to do a little LSD.
Ooh.
Long, slow distance. Okay. You're going to do 100,
cool.
Which is four lengths or two laps.
Okay.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, without stopping. And now you have to have, this has to be LSD. It has to be nice and slow with long stroke length,
uh-huh.
Or you're going to get fatigued and you won't be able to finish the 100. Does that make sense?
Yep.
So on this 100, just take it nice and easy.
Okay.
And focus on nice long stroke length. And get into a rhythm in your breathing. Your breathing looks really good.
Okay.
And again, bilateral breathing really evens out the stroke. Okay?
Uh-huh.
And don't even worry about your kick. Your kick looks good, man. All right, let's swim 100. And go! Excellent. Under the water, extend out. Watch out for the wall. That's it. Nice long stroke length, long stroke length. High elbow. Push out under the water, extend out, keep it nice and slow. Excellent, and rest. Good LSD.
Yeah,
good long, slow distance.
Suffer, doesn't it, a little bit when...
That's why I want you to start doing 50s and 100s, because it's going to force you to have proper technique. Because once you start shortening your stroke length, lifting your head, having a 12-beat kick, you're going to have this cascading effect. And what's going to happen is it's going to super fatigue you. Okay? You want to be at a point where, like, if my life depended on it, I could probably swim 20 or 30 miles. Because I'm real efficient. I'm swimming for a long, long time. It's all about that efficiency. You want to get to the point where you can, you know, do the longer distances real efficiently. So did you notice that last lap you were kind of suffering a little bit because your stroke length was getting shorter. You started to cross over a little bit and you started to kick a little bit faster. That's when you don't want to do that.
Mm-hmm.
All right? So how you feeling, man?
Feels good.
Yeah. You've been in the pool about an hour.
Wow.
Yeah. I think you're done.
Great.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Awesome.
Since this was my very first professional swim lesson, I didn't get too fancy with it. As you saw in the video, John kept me focused and had me drill a few basic moves over and over again. This swimming workout reflects this and is intended mostly for beginners to help them learn proper stroke technique. If you find this workout to be too easy, feel free to increase the amount of laps as needed. If you'd like to learn more about my upcoming movie, please visit iwantabsmovie.com. You can also check out what my coach John is doing at coachhacker.com. That's coachhacker with one H.com.